I'm going to work on my car inside it. It's a wheeled tent. When I'm done using the tent, I'll roll it into the garage. Woo! It's a lot harder to cut this today. Holy smokes, this thing got hard. I'm glad I did most of the cutting while it was still not cured all the way. That was a smart move. I need a tornado tent so it will last. It's gonna have all my stuff in it. I don't want it to blow down the first time it's stuck in a storm. It's gotta be strong. It's gotta last me my whole life without needing to be upgraded or replaced. Maybe some minor repairs, but this tent is designed to last for life. It's gonna be my garage because I don't have a garage. And I need a garage, bad. I'm a mechanic, and I'm sick of working out in the elements. I'm sick of bugs, I'm sick of cold, I'm sick of rain. I'm sick of sun. I want a nice, comfy garage. And this tent will provide that. I have a lot of big plans in the automotive world. A lot of cars to fix. Oh, this thing is strong as heck, man. You guys think this thing's weak? I mean, this thing is strong. Ah! I just pushed 80 pounds of pressure on it. It didn't even budge. This thing is strong. I mean, real strong. This thing would hold maybe 150 pounds of weight on it. I weigh 400 pounds, it wouldn't hold my weight. But it's not designed to hold the weight of a large man. I do read audiobooks. They're not going to be breaking points! Learn engineering! Did you not know I'm a master of engineering? The holes are the last breaking point. They're not going to affect the breaking at all. The way this would break is the two outer walls would bow outward like that. Or this vertical pipe would rip that way. It would go like this. Boom. So that's why I made nice thick splines here. To strengthen it, preventing that. You have to visualize the failure in an animated form. You have to see it breaking in your mind. And then you have to build it in such a way that it's reinforced in the areas that your mind saw would be the weak points. These holes are not one of those areas. They will not be a weak point. Other places would give way before those holes. It's not smooth, it needs to be scraped to make it smooth. There's little burrs and ridges and outcroppings that need to be trimmed off. I never sleep in my chair. I'm a hard worker. Whoa! Thanks for the host, Cat Central. I'm doing science, guys. What's up, OMG? Actually, I'm doing fiberglassing. I'll show you what I'm making. I'm building a tent on wheels, and so here's one wheel, and this wheel works. I made this out of cardboard and hot glue and then fiberglass, so it's hard. It's solid. And yeah, it's kind of like a shopping cart wheel, homemade. I use this. This wheel came from a red wagon. I cut it off the wagon. So I have to make four of these. I'm making the rest right now. Ultimately, I'm going to create a tent on wheels. That's the end goal. The tent, I'm going to work on cars within. I'm sick of working in my driveway and freezing my butt off or getting bit by mosquitoes. So, it's a mobile pop-up tent. I'm building a robot, but today's not... Well, actually, no, today is robot day, but I'll be working on that later tonight. I'll be doing electronics for that. I'm building a power supply for it. From scratch. It has to be a special power supply. I designed one. I pretty much, just make stuff on stream. I make stuff, and I do computer programming and electronics. My stream is kind of boring a lot of the time because making stuff can be boring to actually watch, but I would say it's a good stream for people that just want to chill and chit-chat, and it's a stream that's kind of cool to come back to every now and then to see what my progress is on my various projects. I have tons of projects. I'm doing so much stuff. You wouldn't believe it. I have a list of ongoing projects actually in my Twitch description at the near the bottom. Thanks for the follows, guys. My passion in life is making things. And eventually, once I build my first robot, it's going to help me build more robots, including building the rest of itself. And it's also going to help me build things. So once I then have several robots made by themselves, they'll be self-replicating, then I'll really be able to turn up the speed on my projects, because my robots will help me make everything I want to make. Kind of like Iron Man needed Jarvis to help him make the Iron Man suit. He didn't actually make it himself. And in later Iron Man suits, he had robots build the whole suit. He didn't even make anything at that point. So that's kind of what I'm aiming toward, is having robots help me make the next thing. I work on my stomach because I like to be comfortable and reclined so I can work 12 hours a day with no back troubles and no breaks required. So I do all my work sitting in a reclined position. I don't know why more people don't aim for that. Why work uncomfortable? I prefer to work as comfortable as possible. For the follow, Big Fruit and Hallander. I love when the epoxy starts getting warm to the touch. It's getting very warm now. This is 5-minute epoxy. This is like my second coat of epoxy. You just gotta keep adding coats until everything gets smooth enough and strong enough. Somebody said I should keep the gloves inside the vacuum chamber, so I'm doing that. I used to throw them in the garbage next to me, but then I could breathe those fumes off the gloves. So I'm keeping everything with epoxy inside this vacuum chamber, so no fumes whatsoever could possibly be breathed in. Hey, thanks for it. Thanks for the bits, man. Quiet, mailbox. Doing electronics later! Break. Whew. No!